Hello, this is Professor Zaman. Welcome to Hasan Zaman educational video series. This video is in our DC circuit series. In this video, we discuss how to solve series DC circuits. So from the name, it appears the elements in the circuit will be in series. Series means one after another. In any electrical circuit, you need to have a voltage source, otherwise there will be no current. We have draw a voltage source here. And let's draw a few resistors. Let's assume this is the ground mode. Assume this is 12 volt battery. This is 3 ohm. This is 2 ohm. And this is 1 ohm. Let's also name them. Say this is R1, R2, R3. And let's also name this element, let's call this E, the battery. As we know, to solve a circuit means we need to find the voltages at different nodes and also across different elements. And most importantly, we need to find the current in a circuit. There could be multiple currents in a circuit or in a complex circuit. This is a simple circuit. In this case, there will be just one current flowing in this circuit. The purpose of this ground node is basically fixing the voltage at this node. So voltage at this node is 0 volt. And what is important to notice here, no current is flowing into the ground or out of the ground, because current is flowing only in this circuit. There has to be a circular path for current to flow. Because if the current goes into the ground here, it has no way to come back. So there will be no current going into the ground here. Okay, let's assume the direction of the current. So let's say this is the direction of the current. And we can prove that the total resistance of a series circuit is simply sum of the individual resistor values. So if we replace these three resistors with one resistor, that circuit will be like this. And value of this resistor, let's call this RT, will be sum of these three resistors, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3, that is 3 plus 2, 5, 6 ohm. So the current here will be 12 volt, RT, so 12 volt over 6 ohm, 2 ampere. The current is 2 ampere. So this is just a combined resistor of these three resistors. Equivalent resistor. So, but actually in the circuit there are three resistors. And this current will be still 2 ampere. So in the path to solve the circuit, we have just found the current. And in this case, that is the most important thing to find. Once we find the current, we can also find other required things, the voltages. We already know the voltage here is 12 volt. Now, what is the voltage across this resistor? First of all, every voltage has two things, polarity and magnitude. And what is the polarity here? The current is flowing this way. So that means, as we discussed before in another video, that voltage will be dropped this way. So that means voltage will be reduced on the right side than what is on the left side. So we put the plus sign on the side where the voltage is higher. So we'll put plus on this side and minus on this side. And how much is the voltage drop? It is given by Ohm's law. So if we name this voltage drop VR1, that will be I times R1. This comes from Ohm's law. That means 2 times 3, 6 volt. So VR1 is 6 volt. Similarly, you can find this voltage, and here again the current is flowing this way, so voltage will reduce this way. So we put plus at the top and minus at the bottom, and the voltage drop will be again using the Ohm's law, I times R2 will be 2 times 2, 4 volt. Similarly, we can find the voltage drop here, and it will be 2 times 1 amperes, 2 volt. So see, the 12 volt that was caused by this battery, voltage rise of 12 volt, is being dropped by these three resistors. This is dropping 6 volt, this is dropping 4 volt, and this is dropping 2 volt. You sum them up, 12 volt. So this gives a very important formula, we call it Kirchhoff's voltage law, that in a circuit, closed circuit, sum of voltage rises will be equal to sum of voltage drops. In another video, we'll discuss that in more detail. All the voltages have polarities. The high voltage side has plus sign, the lower voltage side has minus sign. Ohm's law is very important and very powerful, but you have to apply it appropriately, correctly. Suppose if we apply, try to find current in this resistor, and if we divide 12 by 3, that will be wrong. 12 by 3 is 4 ampere. Now we see current is actually 2 ampere. And why that is wrong? Because 12 volt is not the voltage drop of this resistor. The voltage drop of this resistor R1 is 6 volt. So if you divide 6 by 3, then you get correct current 2 ampere. And here again, if you divide 4 volt by 2 ohm, you again get 2 ampere. And here 2 volt by 1 ohm, you again get 2 ampere. So the correct way to apply Ohm's law is, you have to divide the voltage drop of the resistor by its value, not another thing's voltage. This is another thing here, the battery. Okay? Many new students or new learners make this mistake. They quickly take the voltage and divide it by resistor and hopes to get the current value, but that would be wrong. You have to find the voltage of the resistor, then you can divide it by the resistor value, then you will get the current. So we are pretty much done with the DC series circuit here. Just one other thing people sometimes call is VDR, voltage rule, VDR, voltage divider rule can be applied to a series DC circuit. So this 12 volt is being divided in three resistors, and if you want to find the voltage VR1, we found it here. Let's do it one more time. So VR1 is equal to I times R1 times R1. So we can write VR1 is R1 by RT times E. And similarly, you can find VR2 and VR3, and all of them will cut with the shape of this shape. And in general, you can write VRN equals RN. RT is the total equivalent resistance. Okay? So this is the voltage divider rule. Suppose you want to find VR2. So it will be R2 over R2 times E. R2 is 2 ohm. And RT is 6 ohm. So that will give you 4 volt. So using voltage divider rule or VDR, we found VR2 directly 4 volt. But we also found that before using Ohm's law. So VDR comes from Ohm's law. Only difference is in this case, if you apply this formula, you don't find the current separately. You directly find the voltage. So it's your personal preference. If you want to find the voltage, you can use Ohm's law like this and find the voltage. If you already found the current, that makes more sense. But if you did not found the current, you just know the voltage and this resistor values, then you can find the individual voltages using VDR directly. It only saves you finding the current if you don't need to find the current. So that's basically our discussion for series circuits. In another video, we'll discuss KVL or Kirchhoff's voltage law in more detail, which I have kind of mentioned here in the beginning. I welcome you to watch other videos in this series and also all other videos. Thank you.